There is only one God, La ilaha illallah, Lord of both the earth and sky, who knows all the answers to where, what, and why. There is only one God, La ilaha illallah. I've seen the perfection of all creation in every creature and leaf, and I don't understand any woman or man who denies the one true belief. There is only one God, La ilaha illallah, Lord both the earth and sky, who knows all the answers to where and why. There is only one God, La ilaha illallah.
Brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back to the best of stories from the Quran. The ship, the Ark of Noah, is sailing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised Prophet Nuh alayhi salam to save his family members. Sayyidina Nuh alayhi salam did not see one of his sons. And as the ship is sailing, وَهِيَ تَجْرِي بِهِمْ فِي مَوْجٍ كَالْجِبَالِ وَنَادَى نُوحٌ ابْنَهُ وَكَانَ فِي مَعْزِلٍ وَنَادَى نُوحٌ ابْنَهُ وَكَانَ فِي مَعْزِلٍ يَا بُنَيَّ ارْكَمْ مَعَنَا وَلَا تَكُنْ مَعَ الْكَافِرِينَ. سيدنا نوح عليه السلام did not see his son, and he saw his son not in the ship, and he saw his son in front of him. When there are waves as huge as the mountains between Nuh and his son, and he called upon him, my son, come into the ship with us, embark, come, get on the ship with us, do not be with the disbelievers. Because Nuh alayhi salam knows that whoever is not on the ship will drown, will die. But he also knows that only the believers are supposed to be on the ship. Sayyidina Nuh alayhi salam is calling upon his son, come with me, my son. Come with me. When there are waves as huge as mountains separating them, in him. But look how the son reacted. قَالَ سَآوِي إِلَى جَبَلِي يَعْصِمُنِي مِنَ الْمَاءِ. My father, I will go to the top of this mountain. The top of the mountain, the top hill of the mountain, and it will protect me from drowning. Prophet Nuh alayhi salam knows.
قَالَ لَا عَاصِمَ الْيَوْمَ مِنْ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا مَنْ رَحِمْ.
No protection, my son, from the decree of Allah, except whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mercy on, and those people should be on the ship already.
وَحَالَ بَيْنَهُمَا الْمَوْجُ فَكَانَ مِنَ الْمُغْرَقِينَ.
The floods, the waves separated them, and the son drowned. Nuh alayhi salam did not spare his son. That is a fitna for Nuh. That is a test for Nuh. Again, don't you dare doubt that Prophet Nuh alayhi salam did not deliver the message of Tawheed to his son. Did not deliver the message that can turn his son into righteousness and piety. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not distant. You see, you need to understand this. And this concept has to be understood by a lot of my brothers and sisters who live in the Western world. You guide no one. I become amazed when people ask me, how many people did you convert to Islam? Nobody. The answer is nobody. You convert nobody. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إن قلوب بني آدم بين أصبعين من أصابع الرحمن يقلبها كيف يشاء. حديث في صحيح مسلم, حديث عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص رضي الله عنهما. The hearts are in the hand of Allah. Are in the hand of Allah. He rotates them whatever way he wants. You see, you are a messenger to show people the way to Islam. That's it. But Allah is the one who guides this person and guides this one. You don't. Here is Nuh alayhi salam did not help his son in this area, but he delivered the message to his son. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not cast the light that Prophet Nuh kept preaching for 950 years into that person's heart for a reason. For a reason, brothers and sisters in Islam. The same thing with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and his uncle Abu Talib. He wanted his uncle to just say La ilaha illallah at the bed of death. كما في حديث المسيب بن حزم في صحيح البخاري. He said no. بل هو على ملة عبد المطلب. The way of عبد المطلب. إبراهيم عليه السلام. إبراهيم عليه السلام his father. He kept just recite the verses in Surah Maryam. يا أبتي يا أبتي يا أبتي إني قد جاءني من العلم يا أبتي لا تعبد الشيطان يا أبتي إني أخاف الآيات. Beautiful ayat. A beautiful way of delivering a message to his father. أراغب أنت عن آلهتي يا إبراهيم. You don't want to worship the idols that I worship, Ibrahim. Go ahead. Go away. لئن لم تنتهي لأرجمنك وهجرني مليا. Leave. Go. He expelled him. So, you do not guide nobody. You need to understand that Allah is the one who guides. You're just a tool. And that is why you're not supposed to stop. A lot of my Muslims and brothers and sisters in the Western world, in Europe and America, and other places where Christians and Jews are living, they say, I call him to Islam, but he's not, I'm just going to, la, look at Nuh, alayhi salam. He was calling his son in these circumstances. He's in a ship, and there are waves as huge as the mountains between them. My son, come. Ya bunay, come. Irkab ma'ana, ya bunay. Come with us, my son. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam talking to his uncle Abu Talib in the bed of death. His uncle is dying, he's leaving, but yet he's still inviting him to Islam. So don't say I kept calling this person but he's not answering khalas and then you pass a ruling that he's not going to become a Muslim. You never know. The time that you stop may be the time when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will turn that heart on to accept the message of Islam. You never know when. Subhanallah. There is a beautiful story, Shu'ba, one of the people who narrated the story. Somebody, his name is just slipped off my memory, but he's one of the narrator of the hadith as well. He used to be drinking alcohol and very bad person. And he was walking and he saw Shu'ba ibn al-Hajjaj is one of the very elite in narrating hadith. So he saw the people surrounding him, surrounding this person. So he was drunk and he wanted to make fun out of Shu'ba. Shu'ba is, and he went and he, Sayyidina Shu'ba was, rahimahullah, was riding his camel. So he held the camel and he said, who are you? He's drunk. Who are you? Qala Shu'ba. He said, Shu'ba. Look at his name is Al-Qa'nabi. I remember his name. Al-Qa'nabi. He said, who? Al-Qa'nabi told him, Wama Shu'ba. Normally you don't use ma. With وَمَا شُعْبَة. What is شُعْبَة? You're supposed to say who is شُعْبَة? وَمَن شُعْبَة? قال وَمَا شُعْبَة? He's drunk. He's making fun out of شُعْبَة. Look at the patience of Sayyidina شُعْبَة. قَالَ مُحَدِّث. Somebody who narrates the hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. القعنبي tells شُعْبَة حَدِّثْنِي حَدِيث. He's making fun out of him. He's drunk. Making fun out of him. حَدِّثْنِي حَدِيث. Tell me one hadith. Look, Sayyidina Shu'ba, rahimahullah, he narrated this hadith في البخاري, حدثني so and so, and he ساق السند, and then he said, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إن مما أدرك الناس من كلام النبوة, إن لم تستحي فافعل ما تشاء. If you don't have حياء, if you're not, يعني have some blood running in your veins, here you are disrespecting me, do as you please. You cannot imagine these words got into the heart of this drunk man. He understood exactly what this hadith meant. And he understood exactly what Shu'bah meant. He went home, destroyed all the alcohol. All the he dismissed all of his bad friends.
And he became one of the best people who narrate the hadith in this ummah, Al-Qa'nabi. He was drunk. So you never know. That's what we get. Even so, your son or your daughter are not righteous and pious, you cannot say no. Keep giving them da'wah. Keep giving them da'wah. Don't give up on them. You have to try. You have to try with them. Second thing that we, again, something that I shared with the story of Adam, is the affliction. This is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to you, that you get tested, that your own child, meanwhile you are a good person, is not righteous and pious. You just have to accept it. But at the same time, don't despair. Don't despair from the the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One last thing that we learn from this story, that the ark that will save you, brothers and sisters in Islam, is Iman. You know, subhanallah, imagine Iman is the ark of Noah. Anybody who believed in Allah, believed in La ilaha illallah, was on that ship. He was spared. And they actually, that's why they call Nuh alayhi salam the second Adam, the second father of the humanity. Because the human race was saved in that ship. If you want to be saved in this world, get on the ark of Islam. Say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. And go ahead and follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The ark is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Brothers and sisters in Islam, if you want to be saved, if you want to be on that ark of salvation, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah is the way to go. Al-Quran was sunnah, based on the understanding of the three righteous generations, خَيْرُ النَّاسِ قَرْنِي ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونَهُمْ ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونَهُمْ. The first three generations of the Muslims. This is the ark that will save you from this world and will give you Jannah in the hereafter. Till the next episode of the best of stories of the Quran. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
There is only one God, La ilaha illallah. Lord of both the earth and sky, who knows all the answers to where, what, and why. There is only one God, La ilaha illallah. I've seen the perfection of all creation in every creature and leaf, and I don't understand any woman or man who denies the one true belief. There is only one God, La ilaha illallah.